Oh, Singularity is a future period in which technological change will be so rapid and its impact so profound that every aspect of human life will be irreversibly transformed. Computers are not going to be these rectangular devices we put in our pockets. They're going to be inside our bodies and brains, and we're going to be a hybrid of biological and non-biological intelligence. Technology feeds on itself and it gets faster and faster. In about 40 years, the pace of change is going to be so astonishingly quick that you won't be able to follow it unless you enhance your own intelligence by merging with the intelligent technology we're creating.
of me as long as I existed. It was so joy-filled. And they were taking me down this exceptionally beautiful path. Not only was exploding with beauty and color, but the absolute purity of God's love. It was at that point that it became very clear to me how it can be true that God actually knows each one of us, loves each one of us, even though we're the only one.
Thank you. go back when I'm dead to the state where I was before I was born, couldn't I happen again? You know, what has happened once can very well happen again. If it happened once, it's extraordinary. And it's not really very much more extraordinary if it happened all over again.
Oh,
back up our brains. Our brains will be largely non-biological, so we will be basically machines. We can stop aging. We can live indefinitely. All of our biological bodies are limited, and we need to deal with overcoming their limitations with one means or another.
There's only one way. which the world can bestow to itself. And that is by the realization that love overcometh all things. Those who have gone before you are concerned for you, each one.
Further into it and see that if our death could be indefinitely postponed, we would not actually go on postponing it indefinitely. Because after a certain point, we would realize that that isn't the way in which we wanted to survive. Why else would we have children? Because children, arranged for us to survive in another way, by, as it were, passing on a torch, so that you don't have to carry it all the time. There comes a point where you can give it up and say, now you walk. It's a far more amusing arrangement for nature to continue the process of life through different individuals than it is always with the same individual. Because as each new individual approaches life, life is renewed. And one remembers how fascinating the most ordinary everyday things are to a child. Because they see them all as marvelous, because they see them all in a way that is not related to survival and profit. When we get to thinking of everything in terms of survival and profit value, as we do, then the shapes of scratches on the floor cease to have magic. And most things, in fact, cease to have magic. So therefore,
in the course of nature, once we have ceased to see matter in the world, we are no longer fulfilling nature's game of being aware of itself. No point. And so we die. And so something else comes to birth, which gets an entirely new view. It is not, therefore, natural for us to wish to prolong life indefinitely. But we live in a culture where it has been rubbed into us in every conceivable way that to die is a terrible thing. And that is a tremendous disease from which our culture in particular suffers.
Thank you very much.